So they'll talk about their respective fields, whether it's a microstructures, whether it's a coke oven, that is a sinter plant, everywhere they talk about innovation. But my only purpose of giving a small presentation to introduce a company under Ministry of Defence in the steel sector, to talk about that how we do innovation in product development, the principle of management what we use while doing the development of the product. Before I talk about a company called Midhani, its name is called Mishra Dhatu Nigam Limited, and this is in a Hindi word where the alloys are made under Government of India, Ministry of Defence, for defence purpose, space, ISRO programs, and nuclear energy program. Why I'm telling the people in the, before the session, people are talking about 300 million tons. On a global scale, people can talk about 1700 to 1800 million tons. 90% of those steel, when we talk about, is primarily carbon steel. So Indian rupees, we talk about, it will be 30, 40, 50,000 type of ten, depending on which product you're making. So we belong to a sector which doesn't talk about carbon steel. There's another sector of 90% left out, the 10%, and 90% out of the 10% is also a steel called stainless steel, alloy steel, low-alloy steel, high-alloy steel. And people will talk about it at the global scale. This market also will move around 1,10,000, 1,20,000, 1,30,000. Today what I'm going to talk about innovation in the industry, not at 90% that is carbon steel, not the remaining 10%, 90% of the 10% is alloy steel, stainless. I'm going to talk about something beyond, which is very, very small. For example, in terms of quantity terms, Indian terms, if you talk about 80 million tons, this market will not exceed more than 50,000 tons. So you need to understand the product development or innovation, how it helps in a company which talks about few thousand tons against million tons. How, for example, a company who is running a carbon steel plant or a low alloy steel plant of a 3 million ton, end of the year he makes a profit of 200 crore, is one choice. Bring coke, bring sinter, bring blast furnace iron ore, try to make, use BOF, use the electric arc furnace, use anything BOT and all the everything you make in rolling and make a turnover of 3000 crore and make a profit of 200 crore. This is one choice. And my today innovation, we are not talking about that. We are talking about do a business of 900 crore and make a profit of 200 crore. It's good news. But only point is that how we do innovation in such sector, how to go beyond India, because the point is that if you talk about, let's say, another metal called titanium alloys, so you need to have a scale. You need to have a global approach. Talking about a domestic market and talking about this market will give a disadvantage of the economy of scale and also gives a very limited customers. So what we are talking about, the product development in such innovative sector, some innovative company, how we have done. I'll take few examples because we are running out of the time and there are other speakers, so I'll just limit 5-6 slides to illustrate my point, how innovation in the area of product or in the area of process take place in such industry. It doesn't mean that it cannot be translated to the larger steel plant. It doesn't mean it cannot be translated to large steel plant. It can be done. We have done for a niche sector, you can do for a generic sector, whether it's a niche sector or railway sector or oil and gas sector. We are going to talk about defense story, aerospace story, and energy sector story. And when I say energy, obviously, this is a story for nuclear energy, not the normal energy. Our company produced a product for all the things, whether deep sea, the nuclear submarine or submarine or the outer space, whether it's Chandrayaan and Moon. Everywhere we make. How we develop? I give you one material and people ask me, what is this marine steel you produce and you charge 30 lakh rupees per ton as a revenue? This steel was developed as an alternative of international material which was not available to the country. And we developed this material much superior than international grade called margin steel with our own name called MDN 250. Obviously, the trick of this innovation was the customer was involved from day one. And in any product development, any innovation, if customer is involved from day one, take it for granted, he'll remain forever. ISRO has launched 49 launches. Each launch, my metal has gone because they were there, part and parcel of development of the steel. So together, they had developed as co-development, they had given initial orders, we developed together, we modified it, whether it's a DRDO or ISRO. They remained with us in launching and they are till date with us because they have been handholding till date. Number of people working with my organization from these organizations are more than 100, they're working together. So one message for people who belong to Alloy Steel, for people who belong to Carbon Steel, can we ask our customer to get involved from day one, try to improve upon the performance from international grade. You did not copy, you did not make the same international grade which other people are supplying, make a specific grade. For example, the strength of the steel is more than 1500 megapascal and fracture toughness is much superior. So having a strength and fracture toughness combination from this alloy steel called Maharaja Steel, you could are getting 80% of business comes from this product only. The second thing which I want to bring to the notice, it is not that we are working for last 45 years on Maharaja Steel. We are building the knowledge with Maharaja, these other grade, and they become building blocks. And when they become building blocks, they help us to develop a new product. And how it helps, for example, fusion reactor, where India is one of the partners, they are looking for one grade and we want to develop, our earlier knowledge help us in leverage. Lot of precipitate hardening steel may be made it, having a knowledge of Maharaja Steel, we could translate those building knowledge that how we can make a PS grade and we are making business out of it. So my second message, whether it's a carbon steel, alloy steel or any steel, that your innovation needs to build up from the previous knowledge. Altogether, new knowledge will come very rarely. You must keep your knowledge management as one of the management tools that how you can build up on the knowledge building block which you have developed with Maharaja Steel. The third point which I want to bring, it has been always not possible by melting people or forging people or rolling people or heat treatment people to develop such product. It was not possible that only marketing people are working or R&D people are working or process people are working. It was a cross-functional approach whenever we had done, including customer also. So we did a concurrent engineering, we did a joint development utilizing various functions together. Whenever we are developing, whether we are launching or whether we are doing commercial launch, we need a cross-functional team, and that approach we done. Same approach can apply to carbon steel, same approach can apply to alloy steel. This another element we have seen, we have treated this product development as a process. All the time it is not a ad hoc, it is not a simple project, it's a business process we have developed. Anybody talks to us for tomorrow, let's say nuclear energy wants to develop a new product which is not coming from abroad, we work together and we say that the business process, how we develop the process, and many of our alloys, total together in last 45 years, we have developed more than 500 different grades. And all 500 different grades has given us the revenue as well as profitability in last 45 years because these were a process, not a small function or not one type of exercise. Obviously, there are two types of innovation we have done. One is the breakthrough. Some of the people from BHL may be aware of some ultra supercritical power 713C, which can work at 550-600 degrees centigrade temperature by the design of the steam turbine as well as the material called 617-713. We also developed for cryogenic engines. So some are radical. Their product development is the objective. There are development where we do the cost as a target value. So we need to develop this product at this cost. So we take two approaches, cost-driven approach and the product quality-driven approach while doing the innovation. And there are few examples which I illustrated can help us to serve our customers. If they're looking for, they know the product, but they want the process should improve, the cost should improve, and quality should improve. Otherwise, they want to develop the product in the shape and the size and the quality that we do. So both breakthrough and incremental innovations, both have been done. Obviously, we have done benchmarking, we keep on doing benchmarking, but when we do benchmarking, that is our starting point. Within the company also, we keep on doing benchmarking. For example, MDN 250 is the great Maharaja Steel, we improved upon MDN 350. We have got MDN 400, much superior properties. So we do benchmarking within our company's product. We also do benchmarking of international launches which have happened. Many things which get launched in international, we try to develop our own product with our own features. Now, these are the few points which I want to say, but how the future will happen. How we have done so far? We used to make hypothesis, make some chemistry, get the output, see the property, whether fracture toughness, ductility, hardness, strength, everything, and see what has to be fine-tuned heat treatment, what has to be fine-tuned forging, what has to be fine-tuned melting. But I think future, what we are doing is use the data available with us, and use more of an artificial intelligence, the advantages are two. A, time to develop the product is minimized. Number two, the advantage of AI is that your initial hypothesis can give you a product which is very